Hey guys, today we will build concept map of baroreceptor reflex. So let's start. Baroreceptor reflex is responsible for short-term regulation of blood pressure. As you might be knowing, regulation of blood pressure involves short-term regulation and long-term regulation. Long-term regulation is done by renin-angiotensin-aldosterone system, and it targets kidney. Short-term regulation, on the other hand, targets heart and blood vessels, as we will see next. Baroreceptor reflex is just like any other reflex, and it has receptors, afferent pathway, coordinating centers, efferent pathway, and effector organs. Starting with receptors. Receptors in this reflex are, of course, baroreceptors. Baroreceptors are basically stretch receptors or mechanoreceptors, and they are sensitive to stretch in vessel wall. In body, we have carotid sinus baroreceptors located at carotid sinus, and aortic baroreceptors located at aortic arch. Sudden increase in mean arterial pressure causes increased stretching of carotid sinus, which leads to increased impulse generation from carotid baroreceptors. Same goes for aortic arch baroreceptors. Increased pressure causes increased stretching, which increases firing from baroreceptors. Now these impulses travel along afferent neurons. Neurons from carotid baroreceptors are located in glossopharyngeal nerve, and those from aortic baroreceptors are located in vagus nerve. These neurons go to nucleus tractus solitarius in medulla. This nucleus gives rise to excitatory interneurons and inhibitory interneurons. Excitatory interneurons cause stimulation of cardioinhibitory area. This leads to increased parasympathetic outflow, which is carried by vagus nerve. Inhibitory interneurons inhibit vasomotor area and cardioacceleratory area. This leads to decreased sympathetic outflow, which is carried by spinal nerves. Due to decreased sympathetic outflow, there will be vasodilatation. It includes arteriolar dilatation as well as venodilatation. Arteriolar dilatation decreases total peripheral resistance. Venodilatation causes decreased venous return, which in turn decreases stroke volume. Decreased sympathetic stimulation to heart decreases heart rate and stroke volume. Increased parasympathetic stimulation also produces same effect on heart. Due to decreased heart rate and stroke volume, there will be decreased cardiac output. Decreased cardiac output along with decreased total peripheral resistance bring about decrease in mean arterial pressure, which finally balances the initial rise in blood pressure. So that was the entire reflex. Before finishing, let's connect final few pieces of information. In this entire pathway, this area represents receptor activity. Here we have afferent pathway that includes glossopharyngeal and vagus nerve. Coordination centers are medullary cardiovascular centers shown in this area. Afferent pathway involves autonomic afferents. And finally, effector organs are heart and blood vessels as shown in this area. That's it. This completes our concept map of baroreceptor reflex. If you found this video helpful, please share it with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.